Now every week, a day doesn't pass without people across the country protesting against the bad nature of the roads. In his budget statement for 2020, the finance minister said a number of roads will be looked at and fixed in terms of maintenance and the building of new roads. Now, in today's edition, we had one of the areas where residents are clearly unhappy with the nature of the roads. We'll be speaking to them as we go along and bring you other stories making news for today. My name is Vivian Kai Loco. Welcome to the City Newsroom.
So, as you can see, it's very difficult for residents to use this route. In order for me to move to the next point, my colleague here, Elvis Washington, has to go through the water to get me to the other side. So very, very serious, bad road tour we're seeing over here. And this is what residents have to go through every day in order to move to their workplaces or wherever they want to go to. We'll be looking at the intensity of the road as we go on. What's your name?
My name is Azuma. Madam, our leaders have taken us for granted enough. It is time, if this is the only way they want us to channel our problems to them, this is the only way we are going to channel it to them. We've been in this town more than 12 years now. This is how our road is. And it's still like this. Hashtag no road!
I'm robbers for I take advantage. And I'm so crying in the videos we said I'm robbing me taking place of people. Police for better me at Chelsea. Police for cars here, their mommy. So corner was a camera, their mommy. A better me. And to me that. And to my own robbers for I take advantage. And they rob me. A crying yet. Say, I'm crying. I'm fixing my young two about that.
I'm Rosemary Opoku Jenfi, the incoming assemblywoman for Bosa electoral area. Okay, our roads are not good. I'm in this town for 12 years. I'm not seeing any improvement. Our roads, not even if we don't call it this a road. It's a manhole. We have cars. Our cars used to spoil. Even if you are going to Ashama, instead of 30 minutes, you take about 3 hours. Why? Why? If you are pregnant and you want to go to the hospital, you can die on the road. In fact, it's very bad. We are pleading for our leaders to come and come to our aid. In fact, it's very horrible. Very, very terrible.
Our roads are very bad. Women, when they get pregnant, when they apply the road, they get miscarriage. So we are pleading. We need our road fixed. If the road is not fixed, you are not going to vote anymore. We need gutters. There are no drainages. When it's red, it's one district, one dam. That is what we have on our road. We don't want it. They have taken us for granted. Ghanaians, we are wise now.
In fact, when you come here and it rains, it's here like we have like the government social policy that says one village, one dam. We have it, one village, one dam for here, without even bringing machine to construct it. The issue is that, yes, we have moved. We've been to the assembly where I lead as the chairman of the BBC Landlords Association. And we were told since last week that they were coming to give us a facelift. In fact, as you can see in the lateral, they brought the guests on Saturday night and yesterday. But the point is, yes, this is going for a short term. We are looking at a medium term to long term. That's what we are looking at. We want to see a gutter being constructed here. We want to see proper drainage in this road. We want to see gutter, not just a lateral. Lateral is a short term. Lateral measure, if it starts to rain heavily again, we will be in another mess.
Yeah, my name is Abdul Fatah. I'm the branch secretary for GPRT, Ashama Zenu branch.
Okay. What led your group to be part of this demonstration we are seeing today?
Yeah, well, it is our vehicles that ply on this particular route. So when the citizens are demonstrating, we have to also sympathize with them. That's why we are also part. Because the road is too deplorable in such a way that our vehicles break down throughout almost 3 days. They have to go to shop. So when the citizens are demonstrating here, we are also citizens and we have to be part of them. That's why we are also here.
How long have you seen this challenge with these roads, and how much do you spend, let's say you, in a week, how much you spend to fix your car because of the poor nature of the road?
I see the road, it has started for a long time. Because this road, if I'm not lying, I've been in office for the past 4 years. And that is how the nature of the road is. Anytime it rains, even in the dry season, you are seeing that the road is somehow better. But when it gets to the rainy season, the road is so bad. At least every month, if we don't go to shop, our vehicles, they will go to shop at 5 or 6 times. So, and nowadays, buying spare parts is so costly. And let me clarify other things. The citizens here, they thought it is GPRTU that is supposed to maintain the road. Meanwhile, it is not our responsibility, because GPRTU pay our taxes to the government. We pay to the government, we pay to assembly, and we pay other revenues. But when we are taking our monies here, the citizens on the road, they thought it is our responsibility to do the road. Meanwhile, it is not our responsibility. It is the responsibility of the assembly. If my memory serves me right, I remember the landlord association, they organized for a meeting between we GPRTU and the landlords association. When we went for a meeting, we met and we discussed, and pictures were taken on this road, and a petition was written to the DCE for something to be done about the road for the past 3 months. And up to now, nothing has been done.
What's the name of the DCE?
I learned his one, Mr. Solo. Yeah, DCE for Kpong Katamanso.
When did you send that petition?
That one is about 3 months ago that we wrote the petition, and it was signed by we, the various transport organizations, and the landlords association.
So when you presented the petition to him at the time, what did he say?
Actually, he gave us the assurance that they will come and do the road. That was the assurance that he gave. And since then, we have not seen anything up to date.
Have you followed up and gone to meet him on the matter?
We follow up on some occasions. We follow up about 3 times. Before the last time we went, he assured us, oh, they are going to bring gravels. And I could remember, after we went there for the last time, it was about only a few trips of sand that I saw that they came and put on the road, and they left, and that was all.
Oh, me didi Anifoli Julius, mete New York area. In fact, I die back one. Me I buy no. I had it 2 M24 from M24 NDC MPP. Obia ni ni muni se. Demonstration here wa hanya politics. And kolabe truck wa mu haya yamu shishi. And kwana dane ni se yigo doctor. Enti ya yiri mu ana ya gas mu nyinsa na o mu da fa anche na pon ye ntimi nya hwe enti ya de ma oman ni mpenifo ni nyina ne se sika o mu sisa adi ko bubu rich adan wa kase kase lawyer for dan enye ye hia for dan o wo ma bubu over getting to 40 plot o mu ni babe si home cathedral you don't want it, there is no road, no vote. And secondly, ye ma o ti asese ye nya campaign enye MPP and this ne wa ho ye person ti asese home cathedral no so si a enye mpanche na be kom eye nipa na be kom se kwan ye ma ya ye be ba sori ho collection kakra ye be tu ma janka no mu be die.
The nature of our road is very bad, to the extent that last 2 years, around 1 o'clock exactly, I heard a knock on my door. Back. Before I realized, madam, they broke through my window, break the bugger proof, break my bedroom door, and straight forward, there's a gun on my head with my kids and my wife, telling me I should give my money to them. The money they kept with me, they have come for it. So quickly, I ordered my wife to give the money out. Even before the door, they were breaking the door, we called the police. They said, they are coming, where is it? What is it? Because of the nature of the road, within 5 minutes, these people, they finished us. Took our money, my laptop, my digital camera, everything, they take everything away. And even after that operation, they waited about 2 hours. Meanwhile, my place, aviation there, to the police station, just a stone throw. But they couldn't reach my there. Before they came, they've already robbed, yes.